Mr. Farage.
I'm in no doubt that this withdrawal agreement is a good deal. It's a good deal because it involves large transfers of money. It's a good deal because it maintains free movement of people. It's a good deal because it keeps Britain in the customs union and stuck with the EU's rulebook. And crucially, the key point, as Mr. Barnier said this morning, there is the backstop, which means, of course, the United Kingdom can be held effectively as a hostage for many years to come. It's a good deal for the European Union. For the UK, I think it's probably the worst deal in history. Something, Mr. Brock, that President Trump has noticed. And by the way, he is a great respecter of the great nation states of Europe, and certainly no enemy of any single one of them. No, Mr. Barnier, I have to say, I wish you were on our side, really, because it's game, set and match to you. You probably can't even believe your luck that you came up against the British Prime Minister, who met every single demand of yours whilst at the same time trying to deceive the British public, and you took it to the big summit on Sunday, and in 38 minutes it was all agreed, done and dusted, and off to lunch. Well, I have to say, we will be leaving on March the 29th next year, but any illusion at home that we're going to be an independent country, I'm afraid, has been shattered. And you know, before the ink was even dry last Sunday, President Macron of France stood up and decided to start to threaten us. Now, I understand the French do catch 90% of the haddock in the west of the English Channel, and we get 10. I understand their interests, but I fear that we're very much now open and at your mercy over the course of the next few years. And the truth of it is, the political declaration, in that, you haven't got to give us anything. You don't need to give us a thing. And that is why this is going to fail in Parliament, and probably fail by a very big margin. Now, Mr. Barnier, you say this is the only possible deal, but this deal isn't going to be accepted. So perhaps we all need to grow up and recognise that there is a strong chance now of the UK leaving on March the 29th with a WTO no deal. We need a negotiated deal to deal with sensible border issues. I wonder, Mr. Barnier, are you prepared for that? Because you seem this morning to assume that the British Parliament is going to ratify this. It isn't.
Monsieur Le Breton.